Alright, so I'm making this video because I'm interested in seeing how far I can get into this. There's a note I just ran here from the beginning of the game, and that's it. Like, I stopped by a couple of one tower and two shrines just to offer a save point. I unfortunately have a Karok leaf as a weapon. I was not smart enough to drop that and pick it up because I thought maybe that would be a part of something. But instead, this is it. I've got... the best I have is two Edge of Duality and a Royal Halberd, which is pretty good. Guardian Sword, Soldier's Broadsword, and Guardian Spear. And those three are pretty much garbage for this. The best bows I have are actually a Royal Guard's Bow, which you can find in Zelda's room. And Soldier Bow I picked up at the beginning of this run. And apparently they just give you a lot of arrows here in the castle. So what I've been trying to do is, and give me just a moment, is just trying to beat him with the upgrades I got while at the plateau. To anybody else trying to do this, I recommend stopping by and maybe grabbing a couple of better weapons. Maybe some... I wouldn't worry about health too much, because usually at this point, like, when you have three hearts, you just get one-shotted. I'll survive a few hits here and there, but once you get to the third phase of the fight, like, you're pretty much just going to die if you get hit. So it's... just think of it like, you know, Dark Souls, where, you know, if something really big hits you, like, that's pretty much it. I have made it to the fourth fight, which happens to be the Thunderblight form of Ganon. I have a hard time getting past the third form, which is whatever, Fireblight, I believe it is. And it's pretty tough, and it takes a while each run. So, as you can see, there's my stamina bar. It's not much, but you can make it here. You have to do a lot of dodging, which involves climbing and using angles to get out of the way of lasers. And if you make it up here, it's just going to be a lot of trial and effort. Let's see what you're capable of. So here we go, and I'm going to do my best to edit out the fights that you've already seen. So let's say I make it to the second fight and die. I'm going to stop the recording until I get to the end of the second fight, turn it back on, and then I will fight it again. And I will do this until I get tired of it. So this is the first one, and I'll be doing my best to explain the strategy I've been using to defeat these guys. It's actually, the strategies aren't too bad if you have at least some amount of gear. Alright, so sometimes he just throws a whirlwind at you, but what you do is you stand a little bit further back, and then hopefully he points a gun. If not, that's what happens. So if you spawn, if you decide to like stand right next to him as he spawns in, that he will always perform that wind attack. But at a distance, he'll shoot his laser, and you'll be given enough time to just kind of sneak by it. Now you have to take advantage of when they fall down like this. So I use my weak weapons to try and make them fall. Then I grab one of my Edge of Dualities and just wail on them. And that really does sum up the first half of this fight, is just being at a distance each time he spawns so that he tries to aim at you. Quickly run past it, and then attack him. Now, if you take too long, like I did, I had the wrong weapon. If you cannot make him knock down, he might actually end up throwing a whirlwind. And with only 3 stars, that whirlwind will take off all but a single quarter of your health. So, let me see. I guess I'll just keep using the Guardian Spear. So, nope, he decided to do this, which just means run around the room. He'll evaporate and somewhere else, find a good distance, There we go. He's used his gun. I can just walk up to him and just wail on him for a little bit. So, now we move back because the spear broke. And I guess I'll go with the Guardian Sword for now. And if you can't make him knock down, just move back. Throw in a couple of shots and then just get out of there, because if he does decide to use the roll-in, it might be too late for you. So we might actually be moving into the second phase. There we go. So it's that easy. It's not difficult at all. There's always a pattern to these. Now with this one, you're going to hope you have a collection of decent bows and arrows. So one thing you can take advantage of throughout most of these fights is you can climb up here, at least in the next two versions, somewhere until the second form of Fire Blight. This is just a safe spot from anything. So this is just a normal arrow with that. The Royal Guardian bow. But I don't really feel like using normal arrows, because I have more bomb arrows than that. Oh, he's about to fire. He'll always fire four times. Oh, there we go. He'll evaporate. Looks like he's going to pick the same spot. And these things won't do anything without him controlling them, so they can float all day, who cares. You just kind of have to get an idea of when is a good time to attack, because the worst thing you want to do is miss arrows, because they're actually going to need arrows for the second half of... Oh, he's using a laser beam. All of them can use lasers, by the way, for some reason, which is very unfortunate when you're in a fight on the ground with him, because now you just have to dodge it instead of hide behind something. So that made him fall down. I guess I'll just hit him with another one. And I missed it. That is really unfortunate, because that's an ancient arrow. We'll go back to using bombs for now. So I tried to cycle between what bows I'm using. Exactly what attacks I'm using. Alright, so I'm gonna hope... So this is gonna be a little risky, but... I'm gonna use an ancient arrow and hope he's close by. There you go. Okay, well I didn't have to, but what you can do... And I'll just explain it. So, as I was mentioning, in the last few bits of his health, what you can do is use an ancient arrow with your strongest bow, and a direct hit, usually to the eye, will almost always cause him to fall down. What you want to do is have him close to the stairs, so that if he does fall down, you can safely jump down without losing any health and just wail on him with a weapon for the last few attacks of a phase. Because you'll always start off right in front of him at this very point. Now, with this fight, I'm going to use a broadsword, and you're going to stand, there's three ranges to this guy. One is the close range, which he's going to do he'll shove his spear into the ground, cause a shockwave. The mid-range is he has two options, which is one to do a thrusting attack, and second to do a sort of spinning attack, so he'll just make his spear as long as possible and just do one full circle, and that's actually really tough to dodge. If you're at the far range, he'll just throw a spear at you, which you can use pillars to dodge or to block, and you can dodge them yourself. However, if you're on the ground and he ever throws a fast attack at you, you really want to be sprinting and you want to be jumping right before impact, because it will want, like, I've found that pretty much every long range attack he uses will kill you in one shot. It's the tornadoes and stuff, like maybe one of those ice attacks that he was throwing at us from the beginning of the from the second phase of the first fight. But most things, like, if it's thrown at you, just stay out of the way. Just play it safe. Don't risk anything. So yeah, I'm going to use this, and I'm going to get into this sort of range. So, you can dodge. That'll knock him down. Switch to a better weapon. And maybe... couldn't do it. I always had a hard time using those powers because I've never been good at just switching between the bombs in this game. It feels like that was a bit more challenging. So this guy usually doesn't do any attacks when he gets back up. He'll just kind of move around the room. What's this? Hell yeah. I've never seen that. So that was close. Almost always want to be able to dodge the attacks he's going to throw at you. There we go. That's the other attack, which is dangerous because it has a very wide range. So yeah, if you were playing through the game normally going through these phases, you'd probably use something a little bit more... You could be more risky. Which is great. Unfortunately, when everything pretty much one-shots you in this form... Oh, that was close. Okay, sweet. You have to be really careful, you have to take your time, and you just have to be willing to wait. So I'm going to switch... I'm going to switch bows here, and arrows. I don't want to just start off with that, but I planted bomb arrows. Now, one thing you can do, if you're really patient, here's something I tried the first time but just got bored of. You can throw those down. That one didn't hit. Sorry. You have to do the remote bombs, the ones that roll. So you can throw these down. They'll let roll, and if you notice, his health bar actually dropped just a little bit. So I'll do that again, just to let you watch it. So, it hits the ground, it rolls. It's weird, it rolled in a different direction. So if you really wanted to, you could spend all day up here, not use any of your arrows, no weapons, and... I don't know why I keep missing. Do this a bit more correctly. I'm getting really tired of this. Usually I get these like all the time. I don't know why I'm missing right now. Throw. Roll. There we go. So you can do that the entire time. I think that's really tedious. It takes too long. If you're really low on arrows, maybe that can do it. Now, the other part of the phase that you can use to your advantage is right here, where it'll just continue to summon these things. That's a pretty easy attack to dodge from right here, since all you have to do is walk up the stairs. So just use another bomb right now, just to demonstrate it again. Let it hit. There. Just a tiny sliver of damage. Might look like it's not doing anything. For the first time I started trying it out, I thought he was recovering the damage, but he's not. It's just doing that little damage. So you could sit up here forever and just throw these bombs. Eventually, once he's taken enough damage, though, he will move locations. You can still use the bomb strategy down the stairs, but it becomes dangerous as the longer this fight goes on, he starts to throw more ice blocks. So I'm not going to worry about it too much right now. I'm just going to hit him right in the face. He'll throw a spear, so get out of the way. That will kill you. He's going to move spots, and I find in this fight he has two spots right in front of kind of the throne there, and then right at that entrance down there somewhere. I think I'm using normal arrows. So yeah, make sure you find this bow in Zelda's personal room, because this actually does a considerable amount of damage. And I would hate for you to just walk in with a bunch of Boko bows, or maybe a hero's bow, or what are the other bows? Yeah, a soldier's bow. The amount of damage you get out of this thing is intense. So I'll try fire arrows. Oh, he's using the laser attack. Back off. Never let that hit you. It will kill you pretty much instantly. I don't know what happened there. So I am saving. Oh no. It's gonna suck. That's gonna suck. I'll use this. And I'll use normal arrows, please. I have plenty of them. But yeah, so that's the scariest part of that, of this phase, is when he throws a spear and uses a laser. Just get behind something. That was a waste of an arrow. I should've just waited. So what I'm hoping to do is get him down in front of the throne again. Uh-oh. Down there. Sweet. Alright, so I'm going to move down here. I'm going to switch to an ancient arrow, which I'm actually doing really well on. He's going to transport over here. Alright, so, falls down, just run over, and get the last few swings in, save yourself an arrow. And then this guy starts, and this guy is genuinely, this particular phase isn't difficult, but he's up there. Missed it. That sucks. I have to switch this. There we go. I don't think I'll use this one yet. There we go. You're just gonna have to rely on those sweet Dark Souls skills. Oh, I survived. So there it is. I can actually survive that attack, but as you just see, it's not very good. I'm sorry, I'm just like phasing out over the food here. But this is actually one of the best I've done. I was not smart, I did not cook anything, but you always want to be at full health if you get hit. There we go. We'll do this every so often, get out of the way. The fire actually does hurt. Maybe you have to have your weapon out in order for that to work. There we go. Back off, because he's just going to swing. That's the only downside about this guy, is if you can't make him knock down, he just swings at you. It sucks. handle him. You know, you can 90% of the time, if he throws that at you, just keep locked on and move to the left and then dodge to the left right before they hit. If you miss that attack, he will swing three more times. There we go, got it. There we go. So you can chain these if you're on the ball. Then we get to his second phase, which parts of it are easier, parts are not. So this is easy. This is actually really easy to do. Just get your shield out, hold it up against him, let him throw it, and you'll be surprised that, keep in mind, I have a, which one's equipped? I think I have a Boko shield equipped. Yes, I have a Boko shield equipped, so one of the first shields you can get in the game. And not only can I deflect it, but the shield's fine. Switch weapons. This is where I like to use the Royal Albert. And it's moving. Now this is where it's kind of... this is hard to deal with. This is the hard part of the fight. This is where I mess up the most, because he will switch between throwing melee attacks, which that still caught me on fire, if you noticed. This one did not. Okay, this is it. Hold on. This is tough. So, the trick to dodging those, as I just did, is wait for the laser to disappear. The moment it disappears, move. Don't even try and wait any longer. The moment that laser disappears, that's your sign. You jump out of the way, and you should be okay. Alright, that's fine. Just make sure, as a note, obviously the fire shows up. There we go. So, we're moving into the fourth phase. So at this point, if I die, I'll only record stuff in this particular phase. Alright. Unfortunately, I'm still learning the strategy behind this guy. It's easy to dodge. You'll throw those a few times at you. Ow! And there it is. I survived, but I'm not going to give him time to hit me. My last acorn. There we go, got it. Is really hard to do. So I'm really not using now. Man, it sucks to use, you know, half a heart. What's this? Whatever, I'll just eat that. There, we got it. So this is pretty much all you need to be able to do, but it's pretty tough. Take advantage of him while he's down, and then back off. Oh, that was close. That was close. As you can see here, that's it. Like, I'm afraid that even if I beat this guy and make it to Calamity Ganon, this is literally all I've been doing. I haven't really looked anything up about this game. I've just been doing trial and error, and I think I'm at the point where I would need 3 more of these in order to... It's easy to dodge. Nope, that was a waste. That's sweet. I didn't know I could switch between weapons like that. Okay. So the shield actually is worth something. Alright, sweet. How easy is the other one? It took all of that damage. Yep, we'll just use it. There we go, got it. Alright, so this one's still in the trial phase. I've gotten here twice. So now it's just got electric damage. And dodge these first attacks. So, I know. It's kind of tough. There it is. And there it is. So that's the fight. When he's all lightning charged up, he just kills you. So that's as far as I've gotten. It's kind of frustrating. I don't think I can beat Ganon as I am. Not because of the health, because that just takes trial and effort, but because I'll just get to him and I won't have any weapons. So, I don't think there's much point in showing you anything else, because that's the best I've actually done in the fight at that point. I knew that I've figured out... Well, that was the second best. First best was when I actually figured out the lightning trick on my own, and the second best was, or the then used it again on him. So I was able to use it twice in a row. Unfortunately, if he wasn't lightninged up, I could take the hit and heal. But since he charges himself with lightning, I mean, you're pretty much, you're out of options. You just get hit if you avoid that dodge, which is difficult to do because he is hard to lock onto before he does it. So at some point, my answer will probably be along the lines of get a few more good weapons and use those to continue the fight and push through it. But I'm going to try one more time, and if I get to the fourth round, I'll record it, but that's pretty much going to be it for the video. So I'm going to head and stop the recording for now, and if that's where it ends, that's where it ends. Alright, so welcome back, folks. I've made it back to Thunder Ganon. And I actually took quite a bit of damage in the last fight. I don't know what it is, but the second half of Fire Blight Ganon always gets me. So, we'll tempted to use this for now because I am actually able to block an attack, which is the most dangerous part, I suppose. There we go. That's dangerous. I guess I'll... No. So yeah, by the way, this is the last time I'm going to try this. I've been at it for too long. This, well, my last shield, wasn't it? No, it was just... Damn it! I'm just getting really frustrated by it all. Don't want to hit him after he does that attack. Just want to back off. Fuck. Yeah, see, that's what happens if you hit him after that. That's all my food, folks, so I got one more chance. I don't know why it's not working right now. I feel like this should be a perfect dodge. It's not though. I don't. Maybe I'm doing it too late. There we go. Got it. Yeah, well, that's all I got in me. As you can see, I mean, I really only had two, maybe three weapons. I think I had three weapons. Four, if you include the the leaf. But yeah, if you're gonna take this on, it's possible. And I think you can even beat Ganon by doing so. But the one prep you have to do before you try is you have to get a good number of weapons, preferably two good bows and at least some bomb arrows. That's what I'd have to say. Definitely have shields, although it feels like any shield will work. I didn't have any Hylian shields or anything special. The most I had was a spiked Boko shield with a 10 defense, because apparently a piece of wood can not only block a giant fireball, but throw it back at the boss and do damage and bring him close. So I think what I'm going to try and do is pick up a few more weapons and give this another shot at some point. But for now, I'm just going to call it at that. So thanks for watching, and to anybody else who's struggling, I hope maybe this will get you a little bit further into the fight if you don't quite get there, but maybe you're ahead of me, and if so, and you watch this video, give me a hint, because I'm kind of at a loss for it at this point. So take care, everyone.